addressing her supporters. Let's listen in.
And thank you to our wonderful, wonderful senior Senator Jeanne Shaheen, who is also here with us tonight. Thank all of you. Thank all of you for your hard work and your support throughout this campaign. Most of all, thank you to the people of New Hampshire for the trust you have placed in me. I will not let you down. I will work as hard as I can every day to serve you and to build a stronger, more innovative New Hampshire where our businesses can grow, flourish, and create great jobs for our people. I want to take a moment to thank my family for their support. My husband, Tom, right here. Our children, Ben and Meg. My mom, Peggy. My brother, Frank. My brother, Frank, and my sister, Franny. And our honorary family members, Liz and Joyce. Without all of you, this campaign would not have been possible. From the bottom of my heart, thank you for everything. I want to thank Ovide Lamontagne for his commitment to public service and for his campaign. Earlier in the campaign, we both committed to each other that we would work with each other, and we will work to do that. He and I will work to find common purpose. New Hampshire faces great challenges in the coming years to ensure that we are building a strong and vibrant economic future. From early results, it appears that the New Hampshire legislature will be nearly evenly divided between Democrats and Republicans. We should see this not as an obstacle, but as an opportunity to move beyond the partisan divide. Throughout this campaign, I have been strengthened and inspired by the hard work and creativity that Granite Staters use to solve problems. Whether it's building a community playground, bringing cost-saving renewable energy to a high school, or plowing our way out of a snowstorm, we work together to get things done. And we do it regardless of political affiliation. That that is the example we all need to keep in mind. The challenges our state faces must be met with the best solutions and ideas that we can muster, and good ideas and good people reside on both sides of the aisle. In the coming weeks, I will be reaching out to legislators and people across New Hampshire, Democrats, independents, and Republicans, to ask for their advice and their help. The campaign season is now behind us. Yes. And so it is time. It is time to focus on finding the common ground and compromise that will result in progress for all of our citizens. As governor, I will always be willing to work with people who have ideas to offer and who are ready to roll up their sleeves. That is how we will build a New Hampshire that will lead the nation and compete with the world. Together, we will help our businesses grow and build a stronger economy on a vision of innovation and growth. We will build a New Hampshire that nurtures innovation and entrepreneurs, where businesses can and want to grow, where young people will stay and work and create their own companies. Yeah. A New Hampshire where every child goes to a good school. That's right. Where all families can afford college. And where all of our workers can get the training they need for the jobs of today and tomorrow. Together, we will build a smarter, transparent state government on a foundation of fiscal responsibility and common sense. We will meet our responsibilities, and we will do so without an income or sales tax. And we will continue to ensure that all of our citizens share in the liberties and the rights that we hold so dear. Through our work together, we will build a New Hampshire that is growing, a New Hampshire that is more competitive and economically dynamic, a New Hampshire that will ensure that all of its citizens can succeed, a New Hampshire that incorporates and honors the talents of all of our people. Now, I just want to take a moment to thank some of the many people who have helped in this effort. Let me start with my campaign co-chairs, Bill Shaheen, Kathy Sullivan, Jackie Silley, and Sean O'Kane. Our finance chair, Alan Riesch. And my fiscal agent and dear friend, Karen Pryor. I would be remiss if I didn't say how honored I am to be standing in the Puritan, and thanks to the generosity of our newest executive counselor, Chris Pappas. I also want to thank Governor John Lynch and again Senator Jeanne Shaheen for their leadership, their friendship, and their support. This campaign brought people together from across New Hampshire. Parents and teachers who care about our schools and the education of our children. Firefighters and police officers and the people they serve. These are the people who want to keep our state the safest in the nation. We brought together women and the men who care about access to health care for everyone. And we were honored by the support and hard work of construction workers, business owners, and public employees who want to build stronger communities. Public employees who want to build stronger communities and a better future. Yes, you do. I want to thank my wonderful campaign staff and the remarkable volunteers that they mobilized. A very special thanks to my great campaign manager and friend, Matt Burgess. And another very special thanks to my talented friend and advisor, Pam Walsh. Over the past year, I've met so many wonderful people across New Hampshire. Some of the men and women building the new renewable energy plant in Berlin, who want to continue to build a new economic future for the North Country. Business owners who want to do right by their workers, but are worried about the cost of workers' compensation insurance. Parents who are afraid they won't be able to afford to send their children to college. Please know that I will take what I heard from you, what I learned from you, with me in the governor's office. And I am going to work every day to keep listening and to make a difference in that way. Together, we will build a stronger, more innovative New Hampshire. Now, we've got a lot of work ahead of us to make progress for our state. It will take all of us coming together, all of our ideas, all of our energy. But that's always been the New Hampshire way. Together, we will move forward. Now let's get to work. Thank you.